Everybody smile.
Amen.
I know you don't want to, but do it.
Pass the roll call. Thank you so very, very much.
I know if I don't tell you about it, you won't notice that back.
The word is from Brother Mitchell. Well, it's good to be here this morning, amen?
Amen.
Are you glad you're here?
Amen.
Glad to be alive, glad to be able to worship the Lord, to serve Him, to be here today with all of you. Looking forward to a great and wonderful, wonderful day. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you for being in the services today. I'm looking forward to a good and wonderful, wonderful time this morning. And I got the news this morning that some of our last are leaving out.
That's your mic rubbing on your lapel. Stop now.
Devil, I think. Get out of here, devil.
Well, anyway.
There you go.
We're all right, ain't it?
Amen.
If y'all can live with me, I can live with you. I'll get rid of it. I think Brother Buddy got it. Thank you so much.
All right, hang on.
Well, it is good. We'll start over, amen?
Amen.
Are you glad you're here this morning?
Amen.
All right, have a wonderful day. Good to see everyone. Thank you for coming. Thank you for being here. Well, we've got a wonderful day planned for you today, right after the morning service. If you're all welcome for a wonderful spaghetti dinner lunch, you're going to be served right over in the fellowship hall. We'll tell you more about that in just a few moments, but hope you'll plan and stay with us. It's going to be a good time. And maybe we'll have an opportunity, if they don't get out on us, we could tell our women folks that from West Virginia, many of them are getting ready to head back. They said it's above zero up there now. And so maybe they could go. You know, I suggested, you know, our president has said that he might close the southern border.
Yeah.
So that, you know, that the can't get in. But I would think, well, maybe I'll just close the northern border. They're at the Georgia line, you know, and try to keep them in. But anyway, it's good to have you folks. You've been such a blessing. All of you. Appreciate you so much. Are you leaving too, Brother Matheson?
Not yet.
No, you're a smart man, aren't you? You're a smart man.
We're staying longer than they are.
Well, you're smarter than me. But anyway, I know Brother Smith and his son are going to be leaving out, but it's just great to have you. Friends for so many years, so many wonderful years that we shared here together. God has been so good to us. And ushers are coming down this morning. Ushers, are you on your way? Yes, they are. Yes, they are. And are you visiting with us this morning? We have it right here. We've got a whole lot. Give Brother Will a card. I want him to fill it home. Any other visitors? Any other visitors this morning? Thank you so much, all of you, for coming. Thank you for coming. Thank you for being here today. Well, we appreciate all of you so very, very much. I want to make an announcement. The ladies, this is Teresa Westerwolf, is putting together again this year. It was so successful last year. The ladies just had a wonderful, wonderful time. The ladies' team. And so if you're wanting to help do a table, you need to get with Miss Teresa. And it's going to be in May, right there around Mother's Day. And so now's the time to get with her, so all the plans can be laid out. So like you did last year, ladies, if you'd like to decorate a table and have it all nice. And so get with Miss Teresa Westerwolf, and so that she can begin to make all the plans and the arrangements for that wonderful, wonderful occasion for the ladies' tea in May. That'll be wonderful. Well, we've got another great thing to announce to you this morning, and that is one of our dear, wonderful ladies, and you know she's a wonderful lady. She's put up with Brother Mel for how many years? 50-some years?
Miss
Adelaide, why don't you just step up here?
Miss
Ms. Natalie, as many of you know, and it's in the bulletin today, she is retiring so she can go to work here. She is retiring from the public school system after how many years?
41.
41 years. Have 140 different students. Kindergarten. Can you imagine 140 different kindergartners a day?
And 140 parents.
Yeah, that makes about 280 that you got to deal with. But anyway, she has just retired this year. Friday was her last day.
Yeah.
And so we give her a hand. Yeah. So the dinner today, well, our Lord was in her. This spaghetti dinner. Yeah. And we want to recognize it. And we've got a little something. Ms. Janet to come and present these to Ms. Natalie.
Okay, Juliana. This is Juliana and my dear. We got together 2 weeks ago to have something special today. Any of the family here today?
No.
That had other things to do. And it was Emmeline's idea for us to go to the Holy Land April the 27th. I'm taking up money from those of you because we got to get it in early. Emily, we appreciate all you do here.
Several years ago, and now they're coming off of the road. I think he's just accepted a position with the church. This is their last appearance as they travel on the road, and then they're kind of coming off the road, so we're very fortunate to be able to get them. Also, I know I'm a little long here, but the silent auction on the beautiful western land, 511 and Alabama Forest and Cross, all out there in the lobby. We, you know what? We could have sold tickets and made a whole lot more money. But I just didn't feel like that's what we as a church ought to do. And so all we're going to do is have a silent auction. And the only one that will cost is the one who has the highest bid. So put your bid in. And you have to get over a dollar, because I know Brother Buddy put a dollar in. So make sure you get higher than a dollar, but it's a beautiful keepsake. Or something that you may want to buy as a gift to give to someone. But it's in the lobby. It's so well done. And it'll be a silent auction. We will let you know the winner on Easter Sunday morning. Easter Sunday morning. So go by, look at it. Take a slip, put your name and your amount, and put it in the box. Nobody will know.
Put your phone number on.
Put your phone number. And if you don't put your phone number,
it's mine.
I was going to say that. So y'all pray for me. I have to put up with a 7 day a week. Let's pray together. Let's pray. Gracious Father, Lord, we're just privileged and honored to worship you. There's nothing greater in this life that we can do than to serve you, to worship you. I pray that thou would instill within our hearts today that sweet spirit of worship. May the presence of the holy God be real today in our hearts, in our service, the choir as they sing. Lord, I ask for special help, even as I bring forth the message today. We thank you. Lord, we praise you. Thank you for our church. Thank you for the love in this place. May you continue to help us to grow and to do your will. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you.
Amen. As we sing together, 460, Leaning on the Everlasting Arms. Verses 1 and 2. Thank you. online this afternoon. Let's sing, guys. This portion of the choir is moving to join you and also Children's Church. I think Brother David's ready for that age group to help him minister this morning. Let's all sing At Calvary. At Calvary. Don't you want 4-7?
I'm a little nervous.
Sweat it out. Come on.
Get on.